First of all, to see your FPS, you have to press F7 on your keyboard. The simplest thing you can do is to go to Interface and turn off the Show Action Outlines and Show Hit Indicator options. This will turn off the white outline around vehicles, weapons and boxes, the hit mark when wounding enemies, and it will save you FPS even if you are not shooting or have any boxes around you. Then you should make sure that you don't have the Generals tab open in the background. Just switch to the Heroes tab. Units moving around and the battles that keep popping up can cause a lot of lag. While we are still here, let's go to the video settings. Now, people in the forum say putting some of this on very high or medium might be better for you because your computer will start using the graphics card more than the CPU. So I would advise you to try the medium and very high settings as well. Now let's see what each option does. Here is a comparison of the shadow settings. There is no much difference. But there are differences on the object quality. Putting it on high, many bushes will become transparent, letting you see enemies moving behind them. But having it on low will make objects like small rocks, tall grass or even structures completely disappear in short or long distances, depending on the size of the object. Don't worry, it won't make soldiers or the vehicles disappear though. In order to see a difference in the FPS from the cloud's quality, you actually have to look in the sky, so look directly at it while you adjust. On the low settings, some clouds will completely disappear. Post-processing has no effect in gameplay or visuals, so keep that in low if it saves you FPS. HDR is a realistic lighting option that my computer setup does not support, so I would keep it off as it saves me FPS. Fast particles will make things like explosions and bullets striking on surfaces a bit more blurry, so it might boost your FPS. VSync has no gameplay effects, and it's often a good idea to keep it off. FXAA and TAA are filters to smooth edges created by pixels. Turn this off to save FPS and make the game less blurry. Now there are 5 more options not visible in our screen, but they can save us a lot of FPS. In order to try them out, we have to first leave the battle and go to the Hinge Sync window, click on File, and then edit local settings that... Now I want you to add this line, preferably at the bottom. Now press Ctrl and F and search for these lines. If you find them, delete them. Some of them might be missing already, but that's normal. Once you're done, hit save. Now join another battle, preferably Colmal Harmet first encounter, and we can check what these 5 options do without restrictions and compare our FPS. Once you are in, press F7 and then the backslash button, and the green console will appear. If it does not open, go to the input settings and assign a different key, or you might have typed the line wrong. The first option is the SSAO filter. It's a lighting option to give objects a little bit more depth. To enable it, type this and make sure you don't leave any gaps at the start of the line. Personally, it decreased my FPS and made the game look darker, so I'm going to keep it off. To do that, just open the console again, press the up arrow key and change the 1 to 0. The second option is the reflections. It does not affect the reflections from glass or the pilot cockpit, only the water. I would suggest you to have this off to save FPS on maps that have water, so type 0. The third option is the tessellations. It's a filter to make textures look more 3D. It is not really noticeable, so it's nice to keep that off by typing 0. The fourth one is the subsurface option, which I didn't figure out what it does, but it's good to have it off. And finally, the fifth and most powerful option is the streamer that max video memory. Having this on by typing 1, it will set all the textures to the lowest setting possible. Now, all of these options will reset to default once you leave the game and join another one. In order to fix this, go back to the local settings.ini and type these lines again. Type false to the ones you liked better when they had the 0 on the end, and true if you liked them on. And on the streamer line, put either 1 to keep it on or 0 to keep it off. Save and close. Finally, if you are still struggling, then maybe it's time for you to sacrifice the render resolution. Also, try decreasing the field of view so you can still see from afar. Changing the resolution will also have a positive impact on your FPS, but the interface will flood your screen. Now here are some things to check outside of the game. First, open the Task Manager. A good idea is to right-click on the HNG.exe, go over to Details and set the priority to High. If you don't see the HNG.exe line, it's because you are not in a battle. Remember to do this every time you join a new battle. Also, while you are here, make sure to close any programs you don't need or use, and go down here as well to close some more. It takes just 10 seconds, so it's worth it when battles last 30 minutes. Also, another thing you can do is to find the power plan settings and set them to the max. And if you have a laptop, make sure it's plugged in. You fucking casual. And here is a bonus fix for those who have Nvidia. Open the Nvidia control panel, manage 3D settings and change these lines. At the end of the day, we all have different computers and software running in the background, so I can't really please everyone with this video. If you have any questions, ask Google. Or me in the comments below, or join the Heroes and Generals Discord, they have a community support chat over there. Welcome to the end of the video. I will leave you with some gameplay while I'm using the 5 commands we typed earlier. Also, subscribe, it's free and you can always change your mind. And if you want, leave a like and a nice comment because I want people who struggle with their FPS to get this video in the recommendations. Thank you for doing so and thank you for watching. Ciao ciao!